Hi, I'm Steven Sawchuk, and I'm an assistant managing editor with Education Week. My team covers teaching and learning, and in 2023, we really invested in more coverage of math instruction, partly because of developments in math education, and partly because we felt a duty to investigate in the wake of major pandemic-related declines in students' grasp of this critical subject. Here's what we covered this past year, and what we think the math touchpoints will be in 2024. First, expect more debates about what research says about math instruction. This past year, Education Week put out a special report on math foundations, looking at how students develop foundational computational math skills and how they begin to approach more open-ended problems. We also surveyed teachers and teacher educators about their beliefs on math teaching. What we found are some troubling disparities. We found in our surveys that not all teachers think that arithmetic facts are vital for students to know automatically, even though research suggests that they are. We also found that the messages about math education professors communicate to teachers in training about the subject are different from what teachers end up doing in classrooms. And despite interest on whether there is a science of math, the research on how to translate evidence on learning to classroom practice is less developed than it is in reading, making it harder for the field to reach consensus on best practices. We expect conversations about these topics will grow more heated in 2024. Second, we'll see more about the implementation of California's newly approved math framework. This document, although not a curriculum, will shape math teaching and learning in the most populous state. Its creation was very controversial too. Some of the research citations and early drafts didn't track with what the framework endorsed. And people pushed back on ideas about heterogeneous classrooms, its suggestion that data science could be an alternative to high-level high school math courses like calculus, and its focus on equity. In some ways, California's document embodies a lot of the different tensions and disagreements in math teaching. That's why, as the state begins to roll out resources and training for teachers, it'll be important to follow. Third, we'll see more attention on a math learning disability. Dyscalculia, a processing disorder, makes it harder for students to learn math, especially grasping core ideas like number sense and connecting numerals to quantities. It is as prevalent as dyslexia, which affects reading, but is much less well understood by educators. That means many students aren't receiving the kind of interventions and help they may need to succeed early on in math. We expect that in 2024, there will be more discussion of dyscalculia and what schools should be doing to recognize and intervene with students who struggle in math. Fourth, we'll see more scrutiny around math materials themselves. Our own Education Week Research Center surveys and some other market data showed that there didn't seem to be just one or two major math curricula that dominate the landscape. In fact, districts are using a plethora of different series, and many are also using online supplements and resources beyond the textbook. Overall, there just seems to be less clarity about what high-quality math materials look like. We want to get deeper into the weeds and understand what's similar in some of these materials and what's different. Thanks for following along with Education Week's coverage of math, and we're looking forward to more in 2024.